Hello and welcome to another Adobe Quick Tip. This week we're going to take a look at color libraries in Adobe. And what I have here is a really nice stock photo, and I like the color scheme from it, and I want to be able to use that color scheme across other projects. Now, these other projects could be Photoshop projects or Illustrator projects or any number of different projects, but I'm going to work here in Photoshop to create this library. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go up here to Window at the top of the screen, and I'm going to select Libraries. Here in my library, you can see that I've created other various libraries, but what I want to do is create a new library. And I'm just going to call this Video Demo, select Create, and then it asks me to start building my library, adding assets and styles and all those kind of wonderful things. Well, I'm going to go to my plus again, this little plus down here that allows me to add elements to my library. And if I select this, I can use my foreground color that I have selected, a graphic, I can add everything. But what I want here is extract from image. When I select extract from image, it brings up this screen. And the first option here is for patterns. And I'll be honest with you, I don't use this that often for the work that I do, but if you are doing a lot of pattern work, it's pretty handy. You can also extract shapes, so creating kind of an illustrated look, gradients, type, and what we're looking at today specifically is color themes. And what this does is it automatically creates a beautiful color theme that you can use in your piece. Now, with this, if you're working on something and you realize, okay, well, maybe I want more of the pink from her shirt rather than the background, you can take that color and change it. You don't have to use the theme that they gave you. You can always modify it by pulling it around your piece. And after doing that, I've decided maybe I do want to stick with that color of the background, so I'll let it go. And then what I'm going to do here is select Save to CC Libraries, Creative Cloud Libraries. This is saved now. And I should be able to close out this window. And now you can see that I have my video demo color library here, so I can very easily get my color schemes. As I'm clicking through this, you can see that this is actually changing my primary color here. And use that in my piece. So whether it be type, or if I'm just using a brush tool, I can use that color. Now, one of the things that I absolutely love about this feature is that it goes across all Adobe products. So if I jump over to Illustrator really quickly, with my libraries open, you can see that it's already made my video demo file here. And if I select that, I have my color themes once again. So if I go and I select this pink, well, this time it's not doing anything, but if I create a shape, I should be able to click on that color and apply that color to my shape. So really handy way to bring one style from one piece into another. So imagine you're creating a marketing piece that might have photos and graphics, and you're working in Photoshop and you're working in Illustrator. It's really easy to make sure that all your color themes match. It could be that you're doing something for a mobile and you're working in XD. Well, this will work in there as well. You can bring these libraries across all of your pieces very quickly and very easily. Well, that's about it for this week. Hope to see you again next week for another quick tip.